Video number two is going to correspond to the second place in the part numbering system. So subsequently, video number three will be the third place, video four will be the fourth place, video five, etc. Today we're going to talk about the second section, which is circuit. And this section starts out with a small diagram of the terminal locations. And you'll see here, this is an 8-terminal switch and a 10-terminal switch. And again, this is the way they count them. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On the 10-terminal switch, it's very similar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And as we mentioned, the 7 and 8 and 9 and 10 terminal locations are for the lighting sequences, which we will discuss in detail in video number 5. The next part of the table is a series of rows and columns. You'll see 5 columns. The first column is SP, which stands for single pole, and under that column you'll see numbers 1 through 8. So if this is a single pole switch in this position of the part number, you'll have either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8. The second column is going to be for double pole switches, and there's a series of letters, A, B, C, D, F, J, K, and L. And now as you read across these columns, you read across the rows, you'll see what the switches do. The next 3 columns are going to represent the actuator position. So in actuator position number 1, it'll show you which terminals are active. In actuator position number 2, it'll show you which terminals are active, and the same for position number 3. The lower part of the table is going to be for special circuits, which are labeled H, G, S, etc. There are also specialized circuits that are built especially for certain boat companies. We do stock quite a few of those as well. And okay, actuator positions is first. This is an on-off-on switch, which will have all 3 actuator positions. At rest, it's in position number 2. Position number 1 is indicated when the top of the switch is pressed. So that's actuator position number 1. Actuator position number 2 is when it's in the center position. Actuator position number 3 is when the bottom is pressed. On an on-off-on switch, you have all 3 actuator positions. On a simple on-off switch, you're not going to have a number 2 position. It's either in number 1 or it's in number 3. It skips right over number 2. So you have 1 or 3, and that's why you see in some of the part numbers that under position number 2 it says none. Those are going to be your on-off switches and your momentary on-off switches. All right, to explain how this is worded here, each switch, as you read across its row, like let's say it's a single pole switch, so it's going to be a V1. That's going to be an on, none, off. And as shown by the actuator positions, it doesn't have an actuator position number 2. So when it's in actuator position number 1, it's on. When it's in actuator position number 3, it's off. One thing to note about the table, and this is universally accepted in the electrical world, is if you have parentheses around the on or the off, that means it's momentary action. So the second switch down, which is a V2 or a VB if it's a double pole switch, is momentary on, none in position number 2, and off in position number 3. Momentary switches are used for all kinds of things, from moving your seat back and forth to horn switches, things that you just want the switch on momentarily.